Welcome to FUNC YOU UP, the podcast that gives you the best of functional medicine, nutrition, and wellness in 8 minutes or less.
Hey everyone, welcome to FUNC YOU UP. This is Michelle Miller, clinical nutritionist.
And Samantha Wineke, functional medicine health coach.
Today we're going to hit you with a little Keto 101. Woo-hoo. So take a seat, class. We're just going to cover some basics today. This might be review for a lot of you who are really active in the health and wellness and nutrition field, but we wanted to break down ketogenic diets, what this means, what it is, what it isn't, who it's best for, because we get a lot of questions about this.
Absolutely. I mean, it's trending for a good reason. Let's talk about what a keto diet is. So it's basically a type of diet where you're increasing your intake of healthy fats, right? But to such an extent to where it's probably 60-70% of your calories. And then you're having some high quality protein, sometimes fatty protein. But the main thing is that you're really reducing your carb intake. So for a lot of people, it's like 20 to 50 grams of net carbs.
Yeah. So keto is short for ketogenic. And ketogenic is a process that can happen in the body where we are usually using glucose as fuel, as energy. And if you starve your body of carbohydrates, you're not getting a ton of glucose. Your body, after a while, figures this out and it gets pretty smart and it switches over to burning fat for fuel. Without getting too scientific, basically, this process produces something called ketones in the body. And so when ketones are increasing, we can see some other effects like faster fat burning. We do find that often people will be losing weight, but they can also have other benefits of this. Increased brain function. We see a lot of inflammation go down in the body, assuming that this diet is done properly.
And that's a great point, Michelle. So, you know, there are a couple of different ways you can do this, right? You can still hit those macronutrient numbers, but be consuming junk foods or poor quality fats. And that's not going to be good for you, right? But when we're talking about a ketogenic diet, we still want you to be having high quality fats like ghee, MCT oil, avocado oil, things like that. High quality fatty proteins, but also tons of vegetables. You know, broccoli, zucchini, avocado, cucumbers, cabbage, celery. We want you to be consuming, we still want you to get those phytonutrients.
I want to back up to the MCT oil that you mentioned when you were talking about the high quality fats, because this is something that's huge in a lot of ketogenic diets. So MCT is a medium chain triglyceride. This is a type of fatty acid that is often found in high levels in coconut products. And because of this, a lot of people will often consume a lot of coconut products to get to MCT. You can also just take MCT products that are, you know, isolated form, but a lot of people will increase their coconut consumption. And I do think that's where there is some controversy with a ketogenic diet and where do the risks outweigh the benefits? This idea of increasing saturated fats, not only from coconut products, but I mean, we've seen people who really abuse this diet where they're having like bacon and cheese every day as, you know, because it's fitting the macros of, you know, high protein, high fat, low carb. Obviously, our concern as we're worrying about someone's overall nutrition is, are you getting all of your vitamins and minerals covered with whatever type of diet you're following?
Yeah. I mean, you can be a junk food ketotarian.
Totally. You could be a junk food, you know, vegan. It doesn't matter what type of diet. You could be a junk food gluten-free person. It just means whatever the foods that you're consuming are real foods and you want them to be in the cleanest form possible. I'm not saying it's a problem if you were having some good quality bacon from time to time, but that shouldn't be the majority of your diet if you're following something like this, and certainly not anything that's a packaged food item.
So could we back up a little bit? Because you mentioned that you're really increasing your saturated fats. And so that makes me want to hear from you kind of what type of people would you say would be good candidates for a keto diet?
Great question. So, you know, I think there's a lot of things to consider with keto diets and when and who you should use this for. I will say, just speaking from myself and our practice here and what type of patients we consider keto diets for, we know there's a lot of neuroprotective effects of a high healthy fat diet. So, and also starving the brain of some glucose. So I think of this in terms of, you know, maybe patients who have had traumatic brain injuries, whether that be concussions or, you know, traumatic injuries otherwise. We think about this in terms of even patients with conditions like epilepsy. We know there's a lot of studies with seizure disorders and getting a lot of that healthy fat into the diet and in supporting the brain. And then other neurodegenerative disorders like MS, Parkinson's, we have seen some decent research. We also know there's a lot of research with gut health in those conditions, but we have seen high fat diets as a benefit. So I think these are all conditions that is worth a discussion about. Maybe not every single individual is going to be the best fit for a keto diet, but those are the patients I would really be thinking, you know, could this be a good fit for them? And then I know that a lot of people will dive into this type of diet or maybe like an abridged version of this diet if they're looking to lose weight. It is not necessarily my first diet I'll jump into for weight loss. I do like the idea of cutting out processed carbohydrates. I like the idea of having a ton of vegetables. I like the idea of having clean proteins and clean healthy fats. But if you're really sticking with the macros, meaning how many grams of protein, how many grams of fat that are required to hit these like keto levels, it's really something you have to invest time and energy in.
Yeah, it's a fairly intensive diet and you want to make sure you're actually in ketosis.
And then there are some risks for some people going into ketosis. You know, people with pancreatic issues, liver conditions, some thyroid issues, gallbladder issues, it's not necessarily a benefit to them. Even kidney issues, you don't want your ketones to be too high if you have issues with your kidneys. So those are individuals I would not necessarily discuss this with, or we would have to be monitoring very, very closely with, you know, urine, blood, and my favorite would be breath testing for ketones in their body.
Yeah, and then this kind of goes back to the conversation we had on intermittent fasting, but I would also be careful with anyone that's experiencing, you know, someone that's in a very stressful period of their life or who has issues with fatigue. Especially women tend to be a little bit more prone to experiencing this with a ketogenic or intermittent fasting type of diet. So with someone like that, I would, if they really wanted to move forward with this, I would consider maybe some carb cycling. So,
oh, it's such a great idea. I love that suggestion.
There are some different types of kind of more adapted versions of ketogenic diets.
Yeah, I think this is a really good time to go into these kind of different approaches to a keto diet. So, you know, we already talked about the standard keto, you know, high fats, then next group would be your proteins, and then carbs would be very, very low, and you're kind of counting those every day and making sure you're hitting those, you know, macro ranges appropriately. There's also these new approaches that are coming up, which is like ketotarian, which is the blend of your vegetarian and you're plant-based, but you're having still high fats within the diet. I think there's going to be some incredible research that comes out and the benefits of that. And also just versions that even I'm working with my clients on where we might not be hitting the macros exactly because I like to use so many vegetables in our protocols that maybe the carbs are a little bit higher because we're using some starchier vegetables in our diet, but it's still leaning on having higher healthy fats than proteins than carbohydrates.
Right. Like the focus is on healthy fats and healthy proteins.
Yeah. And I will say too, I mean, I've never been someone that's really supported diets that cut out vegetables. So yeah. I do think that we're kind of seeing a lot of research just done right now as people are really going heavy into very strict mainstream keto diets. And I think the research will be showing up in a few years. I think they are our subjects right now in this experiment. So I tend to go a little bit heavier on the vegetables and I'm not as, unless I'm working with someone again that has, you know, neurodegeneration issue or epilepsy, some sort of seizure disorder where we really need to be very, very careful about tracking how many grams of protein, how many grams of carbs, how many grams of fats.
Yeah. And you want to make sure if you're moving into this type of diet too, that you're getting the proper blood work done to make sure that you're getting all of your vitamins and minerals, your electrolytes, you're balanced. Cause you know, this is a whole new diet plan and you want to make sure it's working for you.
Wonderful. So this was Keto 101. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. You can reach us at?
You can reach us at Instagram at PhysiologicNYC or send over your questions to funkyouup@physiologicnyc.com. Talk to you soon.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week.
You've been listening to Funk You Up. Be sure to like, review, and subscribe for more daily tips on living well.